this city. Can I tell you, I love this city because this is the only city in the world where you are as grumpy as we are in Britain. The minute you get off the plane, it starts. Even the guy stamping the passports was terrifying. No word of a lie. He was like, "What is your occupation?" I was like, "Comedian." "Are you as funny as Jerry Seinfeld?" No. "Correct." You also drink. You drink like we do in Britain. That's great. Not like L.A. I went to L.A. I heard sentences I've never heard before in my life. Sentences like, "Oh, my God, did you see Larry? Larry had 4 glasses of wine with dinner. I think Larry may be an alcoholic." Wow. 4 glasses of wine with dinner in L.A., you're an alcoholic. 4 glasses of wine with dinner in Britain, you're the designated driver. I've been complimented on my accent here. That never normally happens. Someone said my accent was sexy the other day. No, no, no. This is not a voice you want to hear in the bedroom, all right? I don't like talking in the bedroom. I think that sex should be a swift, silent and clinical procedure, right? Whenever I do talk, always a disaster, okay? The other day, I was having, the sex. With my girlfriend. No, I wasn't, sorry. I just remembered, my girlfriend said, "I can only say this on TV if I say that it was a friend of mine." So, a friend of mine was having sex with my girlfriend. And it got to that bit at the end, that little post-coital moment of silence where someone has to say something. I said the most British thing that has ever been said in the bedroom. I finished and went, "Oh, well, bravo." What is... Five years. We've been getting out 5 years, right? We had the 5-year conversation the other day. She was like, "I can't keep introducing you as my boyfriend. That's so childish. I could call you my partner, but that's quite formal. Lover, soulmate." I was like, "Landlord is fine." "Landlord, what? And I'm your tenant?" "No, tenants pay rent. The squatter." I love travelling as well with no language barrier. That's what's great about being here. I went to Spain recently. It was a disaster, OK? I went to this restaurant. I needed to go to the restroom. I don't want to go into too much detail, but I needed to drop the kids off at the pool, all right? So I did that, right? I go to flush. It doesn't work. I flush again. Still not working. 5, 6, 7 times I try to flush this thing down. It will not go. So I'm like, I'm going to do the right thing here. I'm not going to do a hit and run. I will go out and inform a member of staff that there is a problem with their facilities, all right? I go into the restaurant. I find a waiter. Unfortunately, I don't speak any Spanish. He doesn't speak a word of English. I end up having to kind of gesture to this man. I'm like, "Yes, could you just come here? No, yes, leave them alone, sir. Yes, just follow me. Ici, por favor. Yes, just in here. Yep." I managed to usher him into the restroom, right? I pointed at my poo. I went to flush. It went down straight away. How weird did I look? Like I just invited a waiter into the restroom to say goodbye to my turd. Come on, let's give it a proper send-off. Flush. Rule Britannia. Britannia rule the waves. I looked insane. I've always been very uptight, right? Very sensitive. As a child, I would not go into school if I was not feeling emotionally stable enough to do so. The arguments I had with my poor mother, she'd be like, "Jack, you have to go into school today." I was like, "Mother, I am in mourning. Have some damned respect, woman. And don't you dare give me all this, 'he was just a lion. Mufasa was a king!'" I love that film. Lion King is my favourite film, all right? I'm not ashamed to say it. I'm a grown man, that's my favourite film. I've had fights with people about The Lion King. I had a fight the other day with this girl. She was an absolute idiot, all right? One of these hipster types, okay? You know the hipsters? She had that haircut where she just shaved half the side of her head. What is that? You look like you've gone to join the Marines and then wimped out at the last minute. But this was her quote. Get ready for it, because it is a humdinger of a quote, all right? I was like, "The Lion King is my favourite film." She went, "Oh, that can't be your favourite film. The Lion King is a kid's film." Oh. Kid's film, yes, ooh, indeed. Just a kid's film, is it? Yeah, just a kid's film with a consolidated IMDb rating of 8.5. 2 Academy Awards, 2 Golden Globes that's been adapted into the most successful Broadway musical of all time, generating a net gross profit of $800 million and counting. oh, but maybe it's just a kid's film because it doesn't deal with any mature themes, said nobody ever. The Lion King is the greatest anthropomorphic assault upon the theme of mortality that Western culture has ever produced. It is so complex that your tiny, shriveled ant scrotum of a brain wouldn't dare to fathom it. So, no, it is not just a kid's film. It is Shakespeare with fur. Yeah. Is the response I thought of 3 hours later. Guys, you've been wonderful. Thank you very much.